so good they had to flex for it. Pittsburgh Steelers, winners of four of their last five games, now back in the playoff picture because of it. Getting in the ring with the Baltimore Ravens again, winners of seven of their last nine. These two are fun to watch beat up on each other when the game isn't important. Grab the popcorn then, because this one is to both teams. And appropriately enough, it appears we will be settling in for a good old-fashioned defensive slobber knocker. The Steelers have held their opponents to 17 or fewer points five games in a row. Ravens, only one team has managed more than 14 against them in their last seven. They could keep that run alive, being Pittsburgh's offense is 29th in scoring, spent three of the four quarters last week with just 3 points, and they were not facing a good defense. Pittsburgh's primary running back, Najee Harris, is under 4 yards per carry for the year, thanks, O-line. Ravens defense holding backs to 3.8 a run. Steelers have a rookie quarterback learning on the job. The Ravens have held quarterbacks to a sub-90 rating and have a hefty 44 sacks. Terrible Towers have to hope that final drive from last week carries over to this week. Pickett wasn't all bad versus Las Vegas. His play has been better the second half of the year. He used all three types of pass catcher in week 16. 5+ targets to wide receivers George Pickens and Deontay Johnson. 5+ targets to Harris out of the backfield and a tight end Pat Fryer move. No one had more than 100 yards, but all had 30+. The Ravens, they're hoping to get Lamar Jackson back. At this point, though, I feel like a guy being pulled over getting tricked in the same cow 10 times. How many times can we get a game preview guy to say Lamar's back this week? He's gotten old. Either way, it's the Ravens' run game that Pittsburgh will be most focused on. They have a three-headed attack regardless of who the QB is. Baltimore beat Pittsburgh 16-14 a few weeks ago. Without Lamar, that trio dropped 200+ yards on the Steelers. Pittsburgh will point to the fact that since that loss, they've shored some things up along the ground.